The long wait to rescue a sick researcher at the South Pole may be nearing an end. Here with that is Betty Wynn. Betty?
Good morning, Jeff. 2 months ago, Renee-Nicole Douceur of New Hampshire suffered a stroke. Since then, she's been waiting for a plane to fly her to New Zealand, which is the closest country with advanced medical facilities.
Today is it, rescue day in the South Pole for an ailing engineer. When Renee-Nicole Douceur snapped this photo in February of the last plane of the season to leave the Amundsen-Scott South Pole station, she had no idea how anxious she'd be for it or any plane's return. That's because in late August, the 58-year-old station manager suffered a stroke and has been trying to get out of Antarctica ever since. Her lawyers sent a letter in early September to Raytheon Corporation telling the contractor Ms. Doser's chances of full recovery are reduced or perhaps impossible if she is not moved quickly. Raytheon denied the request, saying her condition was not life-threatening. The problem is the brutal South Pole conditions make flying dangerous, if not impossible. These pictures were taken in December, summer in Antarctica. But there is no daylight in the Antarctic winter, and temperatures and wind conditions can render planes inoperable. The situation is similar to the case of Dr. Jerry Nielsen, who in 1999 developed breast cancer while at the South Pole. She treated herself for months until a rescue plane was able to land in October and fly her out. Doser hopes she will be on a plane as early as this afternoon.
And Doser has worked at the South Pole for about a year now. She said she wanted to take advantage of the good weather window. And we do wish her luck, Jeff.
All right, Betty, thanks very much. Joining us now is journalist Eric Niiler of Discovery News. He has traveled to the South Pole. Eric, good morning.
Hi, Jeff. How you doing?
I'm well, thanks. You've been on this beat for a while. There is a lot of animosity here. Doser said, quote, "I haven't been treated fairly. They're making decisions based on budgets. Isn't a stroke a serious thing?" Have you ever seen this kind of animosity?
Well, the situation is that it's really a tough call. Do you put a lot of people at risk to save one person? If Renee had had a situation that was easy to diagnose and she would die within a couple of days, maybe the decision would be the other way. Lots of pilots are being prepared for this mission, which is going to actually go off here at just in a few minutes. And there's a lot at stake.
That is one of the issues here. No one's exactly sure what's wrong with her right now.
Well, they believe the doctors on the base believe that she did have some kind of stroke. They don't know how serious it is because they don't have the kind of imaging devices, the MRI and CAT scans. That kind of equipment is all the way in New Zealand, so they don't really know right now.
Talk about the dangers of this mission and this trip.
Right. Well, there are three really important things right now for the pilots. Number one is cold. Number two are the winds, and number three is visibility. Right now, you know, I just checked the conditions down there. It's minus 70 degrees Fahrenheit with a wind chill of a negative 104 degrees.
Ugh.
Now, those temperatures, you know, the folks working down there, the scientists and the other workers, they're inside, right? They're not spending a lot of time outdoors. But for pilots who have to land a plane, refuel, pick up the passengers and any cargo, turn around and fly out again, it's extremely dangerous.
And the landing is extremely dangerous.
That's right. You can't get out there with a bulldozer to make a nice soft runway, a nice flat runway. There are gusting winds. There are winds that kick up this very fine crystals that are in the air. In fact, that's the conditions right now. The other thing that we've got to talk about is the jet fuel, the aviation fuel. It freezes at a certain temperature. Now, you can add additives and things in there, but this stuff turns into something like motor oil. And if that happens, the plane is, you know, it's really tough.
Eric, this operation costs how much?
Well, they're telling us that this was part of a regular cargo mission, so they're not releasing any figures. Previous rescues have cost upward of $1 million when you look at all the deployment of individuals, you know, across the globe from Chile to this Rothera base,
right,
this British base, all the way over to New Zealand. It's quite expensive.
Eric Niiler, thank you very much. We know you'll be watching, and there's a chance they may have to turn back, but we wish them the best of luck. We appreciate your time this morning.
You're welcome.